Honor Society. 12 players are National Merit Scholars, 10 in the National Football Foundation Hall of Fame as Scholar Athletes. We asked Ty Willingham about that this week, and he said, you know what, Stanford has a reputation for if you're a great athlete who also happens to be a great intellect, this is the place to go if you want to be able to expand your mind and actually win games on the football field.
I'm still looking up some of the words he used in our conversation earlier in the week. On second down, Jarvie Wooster, who hasn't stopped playing, the safety 47 for Arizona, drives Kenneth Tolan down.
This is the final home game for the Arizona Wildcats and from some of their senior students. You know, it's a tough year. When I was in college at Southwest Texas State, Dennis Francione came in there my senior year, and that whole transition, when you're a senior player and you get a new coach come in, it can be tough because you're thinking, well, I've only got one more year, and I don't know what I'm going to do for this guy. But, you know, I know for some of these guys, difficult end to their season.
New coach, old coach, if your offense gives up two scores, you're going to be in a world of hurt. Stanford in complete control after three. ABC Sports presentation of college football will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations. You know, you might not think of it tomorrow morning when you're looking back at this game and Chris Lewis. So many strange things happened, so many great things for Stanford. Chris Lewis didn't really stand out, but you know what? He didn't make any mistakes tonight.
He didn't, and now this is the third and a half game for him in replace of Randy Fasani, and that's what you would hope as a quarterback coming in. Just don't hurt the team. You got enough talent out there to make plays, and he certainly made his share of plays along the way.
Here's an example of where he does not make a mistake. He just eats the football. Stanford had been 8 of 12 on third down, even though that had been a huge point of emphasis for Arizona defensively, and now Stanford will kick it away.
8 of 12 is 66%. Give people an idea. If you can get to 40% on third downs, you're
That's
a
good.
Very good team. You get to 45%, you're a great team. 66% is unheard of.
That means you're going to put a big number under your school's name on the scoreboard. Eric Johnson had to eat one earlier after a couple of adventurous snaps. This one is clean. Wade will let it go. It goes into the end zone. Stop me if you've heard this one before. Arizona first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Ty Willingham and the Stanford Cardinal in command in Tucson. It is only the exuberance of youth that doesn't know when you're beaten.
Don't give up.
Never give up. Go Wildcats!
Meanwhile, John Rattay will try to bring his club from 32 points down here in the opening minute of the fourth quarter. Tremaine Cox will try the right side.
Another
he
ball.
Lost the ball. Stanford's got it back.
I'm not sure we can think of another thing to go wrong for Arizona and go right for Stanford. You look at this from the other side of the field. Tremaine, as he's running up the field, runs into tacklers and just boom, the ball comes out right there. It was a collision from the outside that knocked the ball loose.
That's Matt Fredericks who forced the fumble. He was the same one that forced the Bobby Wade fumble, which was the big one in this game that Tank Williams picked out of the air and returned for the touchdown to open the third quarter. John Makovic, I think, is thinking about year number two at Arizona right now.
I think he's thinking about the skunk rule. Don't they just call the game at some point?
What else can happen? I suppose get it all out now. It's going to happen. Faust. Still saying, where's my big play? And the top of the BCS standings might move around, but let me guarantee you this. The eyes of Texas are watching every move of Oklahoma and Nebraska and Miami. The Longhorns aren't done yet. I saw that game on ABC Sports. UCLA had a chance to win it. Field goal went wide right off the foot of Chris Griffith. There's the score that is making everyone real happy back on the farm. Washington losing. Stanford's slim Pac-10 title hopes are a little less slim, I guess. They're a little fatter right now.
So Stanford needs...
Now, I was told there would be no math.
The math on this, I've got a calculator here if you need it.
Well, really what it means is that Stanford stays alive. We told you that their only real chance is to get a multi-team tie with someone that they have beaten. Beaten Oregon. Flag is down on this play. But the reason you can't really go too far into it is because the next tiebreaker would be non-conference record. And Stanford, Justin Faust, they still have non-conference games to play because of changes in the schedule.
Dang, dang.
Do you have the CD or is that a cassette?
Actually, I have the cassette. I'm old school, baby. I have the cassette. I got it back when I was in high school.
Lewis on the pitch. Tolan pushed out of bounds.
Very true.
This is a second down play. Stanford can get a first down without a touchdown. Tolan is ripped down before he gets either.
So in some ways, after the Washington loss last week, Stanford, they could bow their heads and say, oh, well, we're out of the BCS, we're out of the Fiesta Bowl, you know, we're going to hang on for some other bowl, who cares which one it is. But reality is, and Kenneth Tolan, you see the numbers he's put up, that includes the 71-yard run that he had a great job with earlier. But in reality, if they win out their game, they still have a chance to win the conference.
Which coming into today is not a great possibility. Stanford has been monstrous on third down all year, and especially tonight. This is going to be awful close.
It's going to be awfully short. And it speaks to the mental toughness that Ty Willingham was talking about with this team. But they can handle whatever gets thrown at them.
Pacelli trying to add another three. He does. Stanford goes over 50 points for the second time this year. All Cardinal tonight in Tucson. That'll be 758 total yards. Tack those on to the return yards. Remember, Stanford opened the game with a huge kickoff return that set up their first score, the field goal. It seems like a long time ago. Had the return yards from the long kick return for Stanford and the two fumble returns for touchdowns. So Stanford's got another about approximately 200 return yards in this game, but you can tack on to those. Gary Love had not been able to get any love on the kickoffs from Mike Bissell. He hadn't been able to return one tonight.
Well, for all the young players who are on this team, they're going to want to prove something to Coach John Makovic that they didn't give up and they keep fighting and they keep trying to make plays and they have something to build on for next year. So you'll see them come out here and just try to make something happen. I think John Saunders has somebody to do push-ups for him.
On the give, Farmer trying to get to the outside. He's trying to get someone to get a block for him. He didn't need it. He's going to barrel through everybody. He's got a first down. A lot of frustration, you can imagine, on this night for Clarence Farmer. His 10th carry comes when his team is 35 points down. It's going to go for about 20 yards. Name you will become very familiar with in the Pac-10 and across the country over the next 2 years. Matei, he floated out there, complete, and fumbled. Uh-huh. It will roll out of bounds. Marshall had it and lost it.
And he hurt his knee, it looks like, on the play, on the tackle. Just struggling to his feet.
Four receivers here in the pattern. John Matei, a healthy chunk of playing time. He will hand it off to Farmer. Big hole left side, cuts back, big time play, touchdown, Clarence Farmer. And the only question you'll be asking is, where has he been all night?
He should have had the ball a lot more during this game.
Sean Keogh adds the extra point. It's a 20-yard touchdown run for Clarence Farmer. Arizona playing for pride in their final home game. The newest 1,000-yard rusher in college football is Clarence Farmer after his 20-yard touchdown run. You see the numbers for Clarence Farmer tonight, and the big one that will be debated, as we have debated it endlessly here, the second half, is not the 75, it's the 11.
He's only the 11th player in U of A history to crest 1,000 yards.
Bobby Gill gets a chance to kick off his first game action of the year. Ryan Wells gets buried. In the interest of second-guessing both coaches, I would suggest to you that Ryan Wells probably shouldn't be on the field in a blowout game here in the fourth quarter. This guy has taken a battering over the last couple of weeks.
You might not have anybody to throw back there.
Chris Lewis will come out of the game. He'll be replaced by Ryan Eklund, 6'7", redshirt freshman, Federal Way, Washington. He will give to Kenneth Tolan, who takes a pretty good shot on his first down carry.
Now, Ryan Eklund, the coaches were telling us about him. He is 6'7", about 200 pounds. He got sick over the summer, lost 20 pounds. So if you can imagine 6'7", about 180.
That means you turn sideways, you don't see him.
But he's gaining it back, and They like him a lot. They, you know, he's a sophomore, and he's got a lot of growing to do, but they think he could turn into a pretty good quarterback.
Stanford, if you're joining us late, feels they have a chance to have Randy Fasani back available, but there's no circumstance Randy Fasani would have to be 95-100% ready before they would make a change after Chris Lewis has been so successful. Not much doing on second down. Ty Willingham talked about Chris Lewis's library of knowledge being improved again. This is the way the coach speaks. His library of knowledge, stockpiling information, this has made him more prepared this year to play. I've never felt as intellectually inferior as I did after our conversation with Ty Willingham. Nothing doing on third down. Stanford is going to have to kick it away. Been an adventure for Eric Johnson tonight. And some snaps. And there's another one. And it's very nearly blocked. Bobby Wade going to leave it bounce. Arizona will take over at the 30-yard line. Right away, a return to Tucson. Arizona trying to finish strong for John McAvich.
I think I speak for all players, current and former. There is nothing worse than having to have ankle on any part of your foot. Any part of your foot. Ankle comes with the package.
Really, with everything that can happen to you on the football field, that is the worst thing.
Ice, yes. I would rather get hit by a safety over the middle than have to put my foot in an ice tub.
Rote throwing deep right side. It is in and out of the hands of Gary Love.
In fact, why don't we bring that bucket of ice right over there? If we could bring that over here, I want you to take off your shoe, and we're just going to put your foot in the ice. You want to try that?
What do you think the chances of that actually happening are?
You want to give me some odds?
Well, Arizona's got a shot to come back in this game, I would say. Just get a chance of. I'll tell you, so many strange things have happened. You get a couple of plays like Stanford had put in their lap in the third quarter for Arizona, and who knows? Crazier things have happened, and that's ended up with a competitive football game by the time this is over. Farmer cuts back. He's not done. Huge hole over the middle. Farmer trying to break free. Clarence Farmer is a superstar, and he's got another fourth quarter touchdown. 66 yards on the run for Clarence Farmer, and he's not done yet. His numbers are going to be ridiculous. He's getting better than 11 yards per carry in this game today. Keel adds the extra point. It's a 3-touchdown game with 6:44 to go. Arizona is scoring quickly now. Of course, after it got out of the barn. But hey, who knows? It's been a wild day in college football, so I need to tell you not to go anywhere. Our Pacific Life game summary. Where do the Stanford Cardinal stand? Where do they feel now? Their chances opening up in the Pac-10. Stanford, you'd think we'd go to 5-2, but who the heck knows the way this day has gone. Washington State playing Arizona State. Washington has lost. That's the big score. If you're sitting on the farm right now thinking, what are our chances here in the Pac-10? Are we going to be eliminated? The answer is no, not tonight. Not with a win and Washington's loss. These are the different bowls that Pac-10 teams could end up going to. Arizona could have been a sixth team at 6-5, but with a loss here, they'll be eliminated from bowl contention. And remember, the Pac-10 champion this year, this is the difference. They will go to the Fiesta Bowl, if not number one or number two in the BCS, and that is not going to happen. Now with Washington losing, they were the only team that had a chance because they still had Miami on their schedule. There'll be a different feel to that Rose Bowl this year for the national championship. Stanford's going somewhere, but they have three more games to play before they figure out where.
Arizona needs a fumble on the kickoff, picked up and returned, and that didn't happen for him.
It's Lee Torrance, just his second kick return of the year.
You look back at the first half of football, and despite the fact that Arizona didn't have any running game, this was a relatively competitive game. It was 28-13 at the half. The way these two teams are playing, you wonder what would have happened if Clarence Farmer had the ball early in the game, if they'd been able to hold on to the ball a little bit early in the game, keep Stanford off the field early in the game, how different the whole complexion of this game would be.
Clay Hart hits Justin Faust, knocks him down. Wait until you get a hold of him, get a sense for the yards per play that Arizona has been able to put up on the Stanford defense. And yet they trail by 21. They are approaching 500 yards of offense on 61 plays.
Wow.
They are getting more than 8 yards per play against Stanford tonight, and they're down at home by 3 touchdowns in the fourth quarter.
That's unbelievable.
Faust up close to a first down. It's joining us, Tank Williams returned the first fumble, picking the ball out of the air, returning it 25 yards. And then that man, Coy Wire, picked the ball off the ground and went 89 yards for another third quarter defensive touchdown by Stanford. And that was a controversial play because it should have been an incomplete pass. On third and short, they're not going to get it. Johnson was seeing high snaps, low snaps. You think by the sheer process of elimination, he finally get one right down the middle in his fingertips. Arizona looks like they are coming after it. They are, and they got it. Arizona will have great field position after Casey Moore covers the block punt. And I don't believe I'm saying this out loud, but this is not over yet. Instead, Arizona led by their backup quarterback, the redshirt freshman John Rete, operating out of the shotgun here on first down with outstanding field position and a chance to get back within 2 touchdowns. Flags are down.
Depends on what color they are.
Wade, Thurman, and Leonard are the three receivers for Arizona. They'll look to strike quickly. Rete, end zone, caught, touchdown! It's a two-score game in Tucson. 4:17 remains, all three timeouts for Arizona. Keel trying to add the extra point. He does. It's 51-37. Stanford leads by 2 touchdowns, and the difference in the game are the 2 touchdowns they scored with their defense in the third quarter, starting with this, the first play of the second half.
Think where we'd be without these two plays. Bobby Wade gets stripped of the ball right here. Tank Williams catches it, carries it into the end zone for a touchdown on the first play of the second half. And then on this, what was a forward pass, ruled a fumble. Coy Wire picks it up, takes it 89 yards in the other direction for a touchdown. Those 2 touchdowns now are the difference in the game. And they hate being out there for hands down.
Ryan Slack is lining up like he's going to kick it to his left. But look for someone coming from the back that might try to kick it in the opposite direction. We saw them working on this at practice the other day. Here it is. And Stanford has it.
Yeah, and exactly the way it happened in practice. In practice, we never saw the ball go 10 yards. And that time, the ball didn't go 10 yards. So Arizona couldn't do much about that.
Did you think you'd see Chris Lewis back in this football game? This is really remarkable. And look who he's pitching to. Brian Allen is back in the game. Escapes the first hit, goes out of bounds, flags fly. Are we using a clock in this one? I thought it was just last one with the ball. Turn out the lights. First and forever. Allen bounces. Not going to go forward. Arizona reaching in, stripping for the football. Shelton Ross is in there. So is Tony Banks. He needs his defense now to come up big. Second and long. Two more stops. Arizona can get it back. There's still a lot of time on the clock. Allen to the outside. Try to push him out of bounds.
Nope.
And he didn't.
The clock
get there.
Because his forward motion stopped,
yep.
And then he was pushed out of bounds.
That's the right call.
Oh, now they're stopping the clock. Oh, I wonder if they called timeout. That's crazy. They scored 3 in the last 6. They only need 2 more, and boy, they got them right where they want them.
Now, the Wildcats will pin their ears back on defense, and they'll be coming on 3rd and 15. Lewis over the middle, knocked down, incomplete.
Now we'll see what kind of return Arizona gets. I mean, they can get a good return.
Forget the return. Stanford will be happy if you get a good snap here. It's been all over the map. Had 2 punts blocked and another one where Matt Johnson had to eat it. Eric Johnson. flag down. So forget it. Wipe this one away. Already had two blocked in the first seven games Stanford played this year.
Now this crowd, which is basically non-existent at this point, is making more noise now than they have at any point in the game.
White knuckle time on the farm, waiting for this snap from Taylor. Johnson's got it and gets it away barely. Wade has to let it go. It took a Stanford bounce. Would have taken a much better Stanford bounce, but actually ended up hitting Stanley Wilson, who was down there to cover on special teams. You see Bobby Wade, he is one of our Chevrolet players of the game. This might be premature, but what the heck. Teo Johnson, who was the primary player, he hasn't been on the field, it seems, in about 2 hours, but he was the player that turned the game around in the second quarter with two touchdown catches and some huge third down catches. And Bobby Wade for Arizona, in recognition of their efforts, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. 2:58 to go, and it's not over. Broken play.
Now we get another timeout.
That hurts. 2 minutes and 52 seconds separate Stanford from their sixth victory of the year. They would go to 6-2 overall. More importantly, if they win, this is projecting Stanford winning this game. It's a little dangerous right now, the way things have gone. They'd be tied with Washington, a game back of Oregon and Washington State. Now, if you've been with us tonight, you know that Stanford's only hope to somehow claim the Pac-10 title is to be involved in a multi-team tie, not two teams, three teams or more, where Oregon is involved. UCLA is now no longer an issue after their loss today because Stanford has beaten Oregon head-to-head. It would then go to non-conference records. And what's going to happen there? We don't have the slightest idea because Stanford, and how strange is this for the middle of November? Ty Willingham still has two non-conference games left to play. Stanford still has to play Notre Dame and San Jose State, a game that was postponed from September.
Desperate situation here today. And, I mean, the offensive numbers they put up are gaudy. It just doesn't make sense that they were as far behind as they were.
Rattay has a man complete. Thurman fell and did not get out of bounds. The clock will keep moving. Bad break for Arizona as Thurman lost his footing. Now Arizona will have to move quickly to the line of scrimmage. This would be like last Saturday in Arizona, having the Yankees come back against Randy Johnson. Rattay, it breaks down on him. Has to do something to get that clock stopped, and he does by throwing it away out of bounds. Got two plays to get the first down, but that clock has got to stop. Up the middle, they gamble on the running play to get the first down, and they've got it.
And they've got the two-minute warning that's gonna help.
Anthony Fulcher, that's the first down. The clock will stop because of the first down. He has already caught a touchdown tonight and run for two. Rattay has another man. Stanford playing very soft, and they are getting burned. Lance Relford gets out of bounds. If you're a Stanford fan, you're staring at that number at the top right of your screen saying, is that clock moving at all?
And if you're a Stanford Cardinal, you're wondering, what the heck is going on here? We had this game under control a long time ago. How could it come back on us like this?
You probably went out for a snack an hour ago. You're just getting back going, is this game still on or are these highlights? This is real, live in your living room. Rattay, under pressure, completes another one. Wade cuts back to the middle of the field. Great recognition because he knew he had a first down. He lost it late, but that was the ground that caused that one. Another big play made by Bobby Wade. Arizona moves the chains. Rattay out of the shotgun. Arizona's made a living there all night. Another completion, left side, Melosi Leonard. Are they gonna give it to him? No. He came up with it, but was out of bounds. Four receivers. Rattay finds another one, complete, out of bounds goes Leonard. He's short of a first down, but the clock stops. Arizona is closing in on 600 yards of offense. This is a third down play. Berte looking for Thurman. End zone just overthrows him. Fourth down coming here for Arizona.
600 yards.
Oh, my goodness.
Man.
And the time of possession right now is 37-21 in favor of Stanford. Wow.
That is unbelievable.
It's better. It's about 7.5 yards per play for John McAvick's club tonight.
This will in some ways be the best game that Arizona has played all year and the worst game.
They'll never forget it. That's for sure. To keep the game alive, Rete floating it, looking for Thurman, incomplete. And that should do it. Jason White and the Cardinal are going to survive, and Ty Willingham's club is going to stay alive in the Pac-10 race.
You know, the people who stayed here in the stadium to watch the end of this, giving an appreciative applause at the end of that drive after clearly things are over, saying, hey, we like the effort.
Now, he'll have to keep it between the tackles, on the ground. Allen finds a hole. He may try to do more than that. He's out near midfield. And ironically, that will end up stopping the clock. A huge night for Allen, and we made the point in the second quarter as he was getting all those carries that a problem that Brian Allen may have is the number of carries. His season high had been 23, but as you see, because they had that long chunk of the game where they got to take him out, he's only at 22.
And you worry about how many carries he's going to have because Kerry Carter, the other half of that tandem, was not able to play today, had an injured shoulder, so Brian Allen had to carry the load by himself, but got some good performances out of Justin Faust and Kenny Tolan, especially the spectacular touchdown run by Tolan.
They combined those two for 25 carries, which was beyond helpful tonight. Allen goes down. Arizona needs to force turnovers here as this one starts to wind down. A really remarkable run by Arizona as Clarence Farmer, after an evening of frustration of not getting the football, finally just took off. His counterpart, Brian Allen, had all his yards in the first quarter.
Which is how I thought this game was going to shape up. Stanford was going to hand it to Allen, see what he could do on the ground. Arizona was going to hand it to Farmer, see what he could do on the ground. And whichever team did the best in the ground game would win this game, but we just didn't get to see Farmer
early. Final play. Knee is down, victory formation, and the flag will not even halt the proceedings. This one is over. Ty Willingham heads up. Oh, he got away from it. You can't outsmart Ty Willingham.
What kind of players are these, man, that they can't sneak up on the coach? Are they crazy?
Willingham escapes, and so does his football team.
You lose your scholarship with that.
An improbable fourth quarter comeback falls short for John McAvick, and they're probably saying, do you believe this game? No, I don't. Do you? Three straight touchdowns for Arizona in the fourth quarter, but they will fall short. Ty Willingham becomes the third winningest coach in Stanford football history. It is finally a final. The 19th-ranked Stanford Cardinal have won. They have stayed alive in the Pac-10 race. They hold on to win it by a final of 51-37. Oh, the homecoming king and queen enjoyed it. The kid was right to not quit on his football team. The final score, Stanford 51, Arizona 37. Monday Night Football coming up. The Ravens and the Titans Monday at 6 o'clock here on the West Coast. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com, keyword ABC Sports. Join ABC for Monday Night Football. For Reggie Rivers, I'm Sean Grady. Hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Stanford survives.